Choosing life
Hello,
over
folks.
suicide.
I am here to talk to you about. Let's start with Matthew 4, verse 4. Matthew 4, verse 4 says that men shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. And so I'm going to stress again, it says, men shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. So we're talking about living here. We're talking about living and how to overcome the temptation to commit suicide. And this is a very appropriate verse. Again, this is Jesus talking back to the devil when the devil went to him and trying to tempt him to commit, when he was asking him to commit suicide, when he's asking him to sell his soul. But each time, each occasion, Jesus spoke back to the devil using the words from God. And so this is an example that he came down to teach us how to overcome the temptation of the devil. And so the devil is going to come at us. A lot of people don't want to talk about it, but it's a spiritual world. It is a spiritual battle. And if we're called for Christ, he is going to come at us. He's going to come at us and try to steal our souls. And so when he comes to us and speaks to us and tells us that we're not worthy, we're not loved, nobody loves us, we're alone, we cannot make it, we cannot pay our bills, our friends are going to laugh, our family is going to laugh, the whole world is going to see us, nobody likes us, nobody loves us, we have to use God's words. 2 Corinthians 10, verse 5, it tells us that we should cast on imaginations and every I thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God and bringing it into captivity, every thought to the obedience of Christ. How do we do this? We have to stay in the Word. We have to read. We have to know God's Word. We have to pray God's words. And if it becomes overwhelming, again, it will become overwhelming. If Jesus Christ was God and the devil think that he could have gone to him and tempt him, what is us mortal men? And so if we don't know what to say, or we don't know what to pray, we can also cry, dear Jesus, save us. He will save us. Recognize when the devil is coming at you. Recognize when he's telling you lies, like he's going to tell you to kill yourself. And things don't have to be bad when he tries to tell you these things. It will tell you these things when things are going well too. But you got to learn to recognize the voice of the devil. And you got to learn to cast down these I thoughts. You got to learn to speak. You got to learn to use these words and speak back to him. That's the biggest lie of the industry in letting you think that it's wrong to talk back to the devil. But he speaks to you, whispers in your ears. You know that's true. He tells you, you can't make it. Your friends don't like you. And these are the reasons why people are so successful. People are committing suicides nowadays. And you don't need anybody else's love. You have the greatest love of all. God himself came down and died on the cross so you no man on earth will do that for you. If you learn to envelope and acknowledge this love, you don't have to die. Christ already died for you. So my recommendations again is to pick up the Bible, start reading it. This is how you'll know God and his love. Eventually, you'll learn to listen to God. You'll learn looking back over your past life experiences and know that you've seen where God brought you through. If you learn gratitude also, knowing that it has to be a miracle, it got to be God. that bring you this far. Because the things you couldn't accomplish yourself, between what you could do and what you couldn't accomplish and you achieved, God was in that gap. So you got to learn to be grateful. You got to learn to be thankful. You got to, spend time with God, spend time in His words, pray to Him, develop a relationship with Him. And this is how we are going to overcome the temptation of suicide. He's going to try to make you feel insignificant, but that's a lie. God knows that you're significant enough that He Himself became man, become a man. God become a man just so He could die on that cross to save you. That's how valuable you are to God. Remember that. And so in Jesus' name, I pray against the spirit of suicide. I strike it down by the blood and the power of Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord, that we are safe in your word, in your blood, and in your name as you strengthen us from glory to glory. We thank you in your name. Amen.